Day. Well, since this pandemic hit our province, the BC government has suspended evictions in an effort to help tenants who cannot pay their rent right now. Joining us now is Spencer Chandra Herbert, MLA for Vancouver's West End and former chair of the Rental Housing Task Force. Good morning, Spencer.
Good morning.
So about 2 weeks ago, we had a legal advocate from the Tenant Resource Advisory Board saying they've received hundreds of calls from concerned tenants fearing possible evictions after BC's state of emergency is lifted. What is your message to those tenants?
My message is we hear you. We don't want to see a wave of mass evictions post-pandemic either. We didn't suspend evictions. We didn't suspend the ability to push people out of their homes, freeze rents. Those kinds of things create a rental supplement. We did those to support people, and we're going to keep doing that because we know that the pandemic has hit everybody really hard in different ways. And people shouldn't have to suffer because of this, even though we, of course, all are struggling right now.
Mm-hmm. And the legal advocate I spoke with said, typically under normal circumstances, if a tenant is behind on their rent, a landlord in BC can serve a tenant a 10-day notice, effectively ending their tenancy. Will landlords in BC still have a right to do this once the state of emergency is lifted?
I think the point you made about under normal circumstances, of course, nothing is normal right now. So we're feeling our way through this. I think we know of many cases where landlords have already proactively said, you know, we're reducing rent or we're shifting how we do this so we don't face that issue. We know certainly tenants have communicated to that to their landlords as well. But the Ministry of Housing, myself as well, have been speaking to all sorts of organizations, groups, and others to come up with ideas to support people coming out of this in a good way. We want people to be able to survive and thrive, not just limp their way through this, but to do much better. So we're trying to find solutions so that the tenants can get out of this in a good way and landlords, of course, are able to still make their mortgage payments.
Absolutely. When you talk about solutions, are there any temporary measures we can take to further protect these tenants?
Well, part of what we did was the rental supplement. So if folks haven't applied for that yet, please do. Of course, any other programs that exist as well. $300 a month if you're single, up to $500 a month if you are with kids, if you're a couple of kids, dependents. So that's part of it. People have been making suggestions, changes to that program, to changes to all sorts of programs. And I think that's our job as government, to hear those ideas, to look for ways that we can improve what we're doing. And so that's what we're doing now. But really, we managed to get the plane off the runway, get it into the air as we got into the challenging times in terms of stopping evictions and getting people rental supplements, stopping open houses and those kinds of things that put tenants at risk. And now we're looking at what is the runway to land on? How do we do this in a good way that we're all coming along for the ride and we're all coming out of it in a good way?
And Spencer, where can people go to apply for this rental supplement? And can they still apply for it after the state of emergency is lifted?
The rental supplement is a three-month program so far. So it's April, May, June. Apply this month. BC Housing is the main organization running the rental supplement. So online is the easiest way to do it. There are some paper-based forms, but if you can do it online, that's way faster. So get your application in for April. For May, for June. So if you apply in April and you're approved, it goes through till the end of June. So potentially $1,500 if you're a family, $900 as a single. But really, if you don't apply in the month of April, you don't get the month of April. So I'd get the application in now.
Okay, Spencer, thank you so much for your time this morning.
Thank you, and thanks for raising these issues.
All right, thank you so much. It is.